Curious, another serious segment. Will they always get every Thursday a representative from either the Office of the Public Defender or from the Ministry of Justice. Now, today, oh, now another special edition from the Office of the Public Defender. We get the director, one of the directors for inside our studio right now. And she, in a person where they took eye on top different things, where they affect different people for inside Lagos State. As long as you live for inside Lagos State, Yusef, you're very important to the people of Lagos State, and that's now why your interests now be some of the things now when they discuss this morning. And this particular one, it is very, very peculiar to certain people where they do business. Because, you know, say for inside Lagos or for inside Nigeria as a whole, and for anybody to grow in business, you must first do it, you must first learn the business. And for you to learn the business, you're going to need to work with somebody who had already been into the business for a while. But we could not talk too far. Make we introduce the director. She done the inside the service for quite a long time. I can call her a Sabinus, or you both say a professor for inside this particular ministry. Help me make welcome Mrs. Olayinka Adeyemi in the studio. Good morning, madam.
Good morning, Naija.
Welcome. Welcome to our show. Now, make we look our labor laws. Because we know, say, now those laws, now they govern people where they employ other people, whether or not for them to come learn work or for them to come serve or for them to come do certain things for inside of their business. Please, chook mouth on top of these labor laws and how will they affect the people of Lagos State.
Okay, labor law governs everything that has to do with employment. And we get different types of employment. We get the one we be saying a permanent one. Mm-hmm. We be say, then we'll give you employment letter. Then we'll tell you all the conditions and responsibility of the company and also your own responsibility, the obligation of the company. Then we'll tell you that one. Then get another one, we'll be saying a temporary one. This temporary one, we say, they will give you fixed time. Say, between this time and this time, maybe now for 1 year or 2 years, now your employment good day. We get another one, we'll be say, then when they call them statutory employment, we'll be say, now for government workers, that one day. So, everything, the rules that govern that one, they different.
Okay?
So, there is another one where we say now, you know, then they call them casual workers. This casual worker, now the beneath, the down of employment, because those ones, they don't get benefits anytime the oga fit sack them. So, they don't even get any rights for in front of oga, because they will just use them for whatever they want to use them for and then discard them, so make them they go. So those one did them. And then we get another one. That one a hybrid. It not be employment, so to say. Now the one way they call apprenticeship. This apprenticeship way is common for our Obodo country. Maybe say person go put in Pekin for one oga place, make it they learn the trade or make it they learn the industry, you know. So that after several years, then the oga will come set the boy up or the girl up, and then, you know, that one to go start in own business.
And at that one, people they call freedom.
They will do freedom at the end of
the day. Person.
So
yes.
This one, you know, it's not informal way of vocational training,
yes.
Because it's like vocational training. You know, if you are dealing with government or any, you know, standard institution, it will be vocational training where there will be, you know, things improper. But this one is an informal one. We'll just put you for the oga place. You go there, you go there, learn, you know, as the oga they sell, as the oga they do in business, you should go there, learn all the tricks and all that. So after some years, now you go down, you go come, you know, then go down, come set you up. It did differently. There are different types. For that one, we talk about freedom. That one will be say, okay, I go tell my oga, say, okay, I go learn this job for you. And then maybe for how many years? But that one, then go pay small amounts of money.
Oh,
then go they pay share money for the oga so that you go they learn.
Oh,
and then
the apprentices go they pay the oga money.
Yes.
Yes, in the situation of freedom.
Freedom.
You say, at the end of the day, you go get freedom.
Yeah, at the end of the day, you go get freedom. Then there's another one where we say, now the oga go they even feed the boy or the girl. Now the oga go they do everything. And they go they work for him as if to say, you don't employ him. And then at the end of the day, maybe 4 or 5 years, depending on how many years they don't agree with themselves, the oga will come set the boy up. Say, okay, you don't serve me. I will set you up. This is what I will do. Maybe get shop for you, buy all the products for you. And then, of course, then we'll look at the place exactly the place where they will set the boy up. Okay, so that one, you go free up. That's another, you know, apprenticeship.
And I don't say personally, I don't say that kind arrangement where you say you go come learn the work, but you're going to stay with the owner of the business. You go stay with them. They learn the tricks and the trade and how the thing they work. So that at the end of the day, in go set you up. I don't say this one is very particular with the particular people for inside Nigeria, the Eastern people, because that's not how they take pass on information and knowledge, business knowledge
yes.
from one generation or from one family member to another. But right now, even though we know it's a good thing, some people don't go abuse them.
And don't abuse them.
Some people don't turn them. That good thing where that person can't learn, they don't turn that good thing to bad thing for where that person did. Give us some cases where they handle in terms of those kind of apprentice situation.
So for our office, we are a bit concerned about this apprenticeship issue because we don't they see and where they come our office now frequently where we say the boy go don't work. You go just reach about a few months to end the apprenticeship, and then the oga go say he don't do something. He still one day, and he beat his wife the other day. He no agree to what he say the next day. At the end of the day, you no go settle the boy. So this type of thing, the day rampart now, maybe because of what the society is, but we feel that this is cheating. This is cheating on the boy. Somebody who don't serve you for several years, and then at the end of the day, where you're supposed to do your own obligation, you then you go now remember all the sins where you know they do. That time where they drama, you know, say you go send them away or you go do anything. Now the time we now reach the time where
you go settle up.
But
what did the law they talk in that kind of situation? How the law they take come into play to make sure say justice they serve at the end of the day?
So what we do, because for apprenticeship, there is no specific law where guide them as like, okay, for apprenticeship, oh, this is what you do, this is what is happening. Oh. Although they infer them from all the laws like the labor law and the employee compensation. And all that. That's when we did use those two places. But we happy say for National Industrial Court, the judges where they there, then they proactive. They also know say things where they for Nigeria. If we know they no take hold of harm, it go just scatter totally. So we don't see several cases where they don't decide say no. This now on bad labor practices. That no, you cannot use somebody for that long and then you now discard, say, because you know, do just small thing, you know, drum, and therefore you do go give them the money. So now that time, now that's one, now we they use so much. We get one case where we get for our office where we say, the boy, he work, the arrangement be say, after 5 years, then we set him up doing own business. And the boy there for that man's house for about four years, 9 months. Throughout this period, the boy no go home. So maybe home come the hunger ram. It don't reach like Christmas time. The boy say he won't go see his parents. Say he don't see for 4 years. He never see his parents. And the man say no. Maybe because that is December period. Now the time where the sales they increase and all that. He no allow him. He say he go allow him for. You know, he go send things to his parents that's what he wants to go and do. But the boy say he wants to actually bond with his parents and all that. But eventually, the boy went to his village
without the consent of the other.
So by the time he now finished and wanted to come back in December, that was when the oga said, "Well, just consider yourself terminated from the apprenticeship and all that." And then don't they talk them, then take and go to their village, you know, because all these things start from the village where, you know, then take and go village, you know, come, you know, agree. Eventually, we call them for our office. So when we call them, you go back to them, say, okay, you go give them, you know, certain amount of money. That money, we won't give them. It's too ridiculous for the number of years that boy say. As we just speak, so we don't take the matter go court because we feel, say, not cheating on the boy. Now, cheating, you're not supposed to be like that. Mm.
Now, very good work on do for the Office of the Defender. For some people, then, we never will enter this kind of situation. But maybe they don't, they think come. Say they won't actually can't do apprentice work on top, so under somebody. Waiting be the guideline. I mean, because this is an informal arrangement, it like is. You talk. And it start from village. So that means say people even there for village, they feel not even know.
They don't know.
Ignorance.
They don't know.
And hunger for inside village too. Some people say, we even still know. Go say, who tell you say my own case go be like this? Make I first go township first. You don't want make I go township. You don't go see life for township. You want to make me a die for inside village here. So really, a lot of people get different opinions. Even with this situation where you don't talk now, so people go still took head blindly.
Without
asking or getting certain information.
Absolutely.
And I for say putting it on paper, but because the informal setting, they know sometimes not just word agreement talk we didn't get among themselves. But really, how best can anybody avoid these kinds of occurrences where they happen? And they're very common for people where they do business and apprenticeship arrangements.
I absolutely, agree with you. Not only for apprenticeship, even for formal employment.
And cultural stuff.
Yes, because people, when they won't get a job, maybe because they never get job for quite a while, and then they could just go into that job without even considering so many things. And it's now only when they get to the job, now they will realize, say, they're not even clear whether this one will happen. They're not clear whether this one will do. And then the now conflicts now go start. Maybe say, now they no go now agree with certain things and all that. So the thing where they say, before you join, before you say you won't do anything, know what you really want to. Even if now for word of mouth, make sure say one or two people there around there. Where go feel be, because any transaction, particularly if it is business, any transaction we won't do, they think say dispute free arise. They think say you na feel fights at the end of the day. So even if you know feel right and down, have people who feel witness say, that day we get so day there, and you go fit chook mouth say this one, now the same way we talk and all that. But the best way to do and be say, make you put them for writing. Even a small piece of paper, you don't need to go and call lawyer and all that. Just small piece of paper so that all the conditions where you agree for that time, you go just do in paper and then you go share them with yourself. For now, at least anybody will want to even the apprenticeship, you go read like primary school. Primary school feel read small. Primary school feel write small. So the best way to do is to put it in writing. That now the thing where I want like this, now the thing where I want like this, at the end of the day, this is what should happen. So that you go guide the apprenticeship till the end of the time of the period they agree on.
But just like some of these business owners they go do, they go village where people, these young people, a lot of times, their situation or their status for village, now only Gary they chop once a day. A lot of times, these people, they are looking for any which way to come up from that sufferness. Because to them, the Fisher Township is their own London. For them, Lagos is their UK. For a lot of people waiting for inside village, we never see television before, watch. They only hear of radio, say radio day. They never see good road. They never see water where they flow from tap. You know, they know they think reach this level, where would they talk? And that's now why some of these business owners, they take advantage of the situation.
I agree with you.
So really, on this one where you don't tell us so, now for waiting the apprentice supposed to do. But let's look at the business owner. Any law day, or any kind of, any consequence or effect they weigh, we go hold the business owner responsible. Because it'd be like, say, from the story, or from the arrangement, you want to take advantage because you know, say, you're supposed to give this kind of benefits, but you choose to take that benefit away from that person because as long as the person don't know, you know, go ask questions on top of them.
That's why we did do this advocacy, and that's why we come here today. Say, if anybody did hear about this, okay, the law where we hide under is the precedent from court, where the court don't decide, say, you know, if you do that, so we're a human being now. Person go serve you sote, and then you no go want to do what you're supposed to do for that person because of one small thing we don't happen. And there are some other sections of the law where we say we dey hide under. But I, just like I told you, there is no specific law on apprenticeship. And that one, we dey appeal to federal government, say make he, you know, shook eye into, so that then go do law where we say it go regulate that aspect of our tradition, because it's indigenous to us, Africa, particularly Africa. And we'll be saying you go put your Pekin for you know, Oga place, make it do apprenticeship. So there's no proper law, you know, regulating it. But if there is law, the Oga go know say this one no, nah, this I supposed to do. Now these are supposed to do. And because there's that lacuna, that gap today, now if they come out now, say, even if it happened for Lagos State, so you know Lagos State is very proactive for everything we they think about what may happen. So even if it happened, if perchance it happened, then if you come to Office of the Public Defender, we will go to court, just like we would they do for this one. So several other people like that don't come. We will say they do go court. Because we see the increase. Now, say everybody will come. They tell, this one is getting too much now. Mm-hmm. Is it because of the economy or what? But pending the time the regulation will be made, there is a place that people can get justice, exactly. And you know,
and get their proper compensation. Now, for situation where we say the business owner and the apprentice don't get agreement, how much they will pay, or how much the business owner will pay the apprentice, and the amount. To the hearing of the public defender, it is ridiculously small. But the apprentice say, now the amount where me I agree with and be that too. And the business owner say, now wait till I talk, I need to agree on top of them. Is there any way for that fee, for that amount, maybe let's say for a 5-year duration, where go support the value for that kind of work and the service we don't render, it's supposed to reach like 5 million, but the agreement where business owner and apprentice get 100,000. And at the end of the day, even to pay that 100,000 is still a problem. If at all that case go court, now still 100,000 the business owner go pay, or the Office of the Public Defender, the representative go try and make sure say that money it change from that 100,000 to something better.
The thing we once it don't come to us, mm-hmm. and dispute don't dey, you know say the whole thing don't scatter. So we go just reset them. Say it's one way. Even the amount where you say you won't give them is unfair. So we go come, because now evidence we go show for court. Say, these are the things where this boy don't do. These are the things where he don't even improve the business. Where we say, that money we won't give him. And we go show the time where that kind of, what's in the column, agreements where it happens. Say, it's on balance. He go pick the boy from
village.
The boy know if he's rich, he know if he, and therefore poverty. Of course, now so you go see, see him.
So that 100,000 is 10 billion you know, never ever seen before. So
and then you don't use the boy do all this. Your business, the time where it starts with you, it don't increase past that one. Even though the law will go, it won't say agreement is agreement, but there are exceptions to rules. If you are able to show that, you know, and in any case. Because this will don't day, even that 100 where you say you want, you know, fits even give them, things don't show. So we go use some other means to get compensation for the boy. Agreement is 100,000, but other compensation for the way you have used the man, the boy, the other, you know, other things where lawyer go just put, where we say you go shoot the amount where the boy go collect for court.
Now, some people, they watch us now and. They're excited, they're happy, say the Lagos State government get their interest for inside mind. Then they for similar scenario we don't talk of, so based on the case study we don't give. But they don't know how to come out talk. Maybe they fear their Oga. Maybe they fear, say, if their Oga actually do this kind thing for them, say, if they actually report this kind thing about their Oga, say, their Oga, maybe their Oga, they help people for their house, for their family, for village, say that help go cut off. But they know, say, their Oga know they treat them well. And they still want to try to see whether they feel endure. Since now, small to remember their apprentice work finishing. They don't know how they go fit even come meet the public office defender. They fear whether if they come meet them, whether they go be exposed one way or the other. Sometimes, okwa, it gets as the situation go be, where the person will be the victim, will be the apprentice. not going to even want to report this case, but maybe na neighbor we see him or we don't follow the case because you don't so say, ha, you are suffering and smiling, though. Before this case pass, be careful. How, what do you go tell those kind of people they watch us now?
Okay. So, like the case where I talk, not be even the apprentices come, or your papa, now somebody, because when the thing don't scatter, the boy no fit go back home again, he no get money. So he can't go hide under one very nice woman. Say, okay, they come from the another, you know, from the same area. Now that one can't say, ah, this one, for Lagos State, you know, say Lagos State, you no go grief for this. Now that one will not come bring her to our office. So if you bring her to our office, we there for Surulere, that's where our head office is. But we there other offices for Ogba, at the courthouse in Ogba, Aja, at the courthouse in Aja, Lagos, Korodu, Epe, Ajegunle, even Badagry, we did there. But we get our toll-free number.
Yes.
Toll-free number, if you call us, then we go come advise you. Whether you go come new or you go do certain things before you come. So that toll-free number now, 070-8060-1080. 070-8060-1080.
Please, you're going to need to call the number again slowly because people there where they actually try write and down. And they don't want to miss any number at all because if you miss and put the wrong number, another line they call entirely.
Okay.
So I beg you're going to need to call the number again one more time.
070.
Okay.
60-8010-80.
Beautiful. And at the number where they scroll on top of our TV screen, I'd be that. So if you get somebody or you yourself be a victim of this kind of case, we don't put on top ground. So please, feel free to call the number. Of course, if you want them, then keep your identity. And also, they go do harm. If you don't want to make them know, say, now you actually call to report the case. And also, the Office of the Public Defender will try their best to keep your identity secret. And of course, the lawyer they will get for you, now free
of charge.
You are not paying a kobo on top of this one because they get your interest at heart. And they know, say, every person where they live for inside Lagos, now important person for inside the society. Thank you so much, Ma, for coming inside the studio.
Thank you. We'll
to enjoy more of this our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.